Hi, I'm Tara from HealingCrystals.com.
Hi, I'm Lourdes from HealingCrystals.com.
Today we wanted to speak with you about eclipses. Right now we're in the middle. No, not really the middle, but we're in the in-between stage of two eclipses. The last ones of 2012. Mm-hmm. And the way that eclipses work, they come in pairs. You always get a solar and a lunar eclipse together, usually divided up. A solar eclipse occurs at the new moon. A lunar eclipse occurs at the full moon.
Okay.
The solar eclipse is when I have to check. It's terrible. I can't remember this stuff. A solar eclipse is when the moon is in between the Earth and the sun. Okay. And then a lunar eclipse is when the Earth is between the sun and the moon. What does all this mean for you? It's kind of like when you upgrade your computer. You put something new on your computer. What do you have to do? Hit the restart button. That's what eclipses are meant to do. They're like a restart button, okay? It starts out with the solar eclipse where things that need to change become uncovered, and then the lunar eclipse where you start to see how you can either get rid of those things or change those things and make them work better for you. Eclipses can be a challenge. There's no two ways about it. Okay, they're not easy to go through. Sometimes they are, sometimes they're not. Like, for instance, this last solar eclipse that we had on November 12th, November 13th, I had a really good experience, but there's a lot of other people I know that are like, oh, I'm just in a fog, I couldn't handle it, it was too much energy. So it really depends. It depends upon a lot of different things, your sign and who you are and what kind of energy is going on at that particular time, where it could, you know, really give you a boost of energy, or it could just, like, knock you out. What we want to do is talk to you about the crystals that can help you get through, you know, and get the, not just get through an eclipse, but get the best out of it. Because it really, eclipses are important. They're the restart button. They are the thing that is going to help you change your life for the better. One of the most important things is grounding, okay? I'll suggest crystals based upon where the signs fall. This particular one, the solar eclipse, was in Scorpio, and Scorpio can be a challenging sign. It's, you know, it's very mysterious, very, it stings. It's Scorpio. Ruby is a very nice grounding stone.
It's wonderful.
I like ruby because it affects, oh, see, I can feel that right now. It affects your root chakra, but maybe not in as harsh a way as maybe a darker crystal like an obsidian or a smoky quartz or something like that. Well, you know, the ruby quartz really opens up your root chakra. The ruby will open up your root chakra and help you to feel the energies that are going on and make them work in your life. I also like tourmalinated quartz for the solar eclipses. Just because it's a mix of the dark and the light, and that's what a solar eclipse is. You've got, you know, you have this kind of dark force passing through the light, but that's meant to show you, you know, maybe darknesses or things in your life that aren't working that can help you get those out of your system. So I those are the kinds of crystals that I like for a solar eclipse.
For a solar eclipse, I went another way. Mm-hmm. I like tiger iron.
Okay.
I like to have
Just talking about the wonders of tiger iron.
Mm-hmm. Oh, we're in love with it
now. It's tiger's eye, hematite, and...
Of course you're asking me.
I can't remember. I'm so sorry. See, I shouldn't do that to you while we're shooting.
No.
Okay.
I can't remember right now.
We'll find out for you.
Okay. And we'll put it in the description.
There you go.
But what I like about tiger iron is that you actually get the strength of the iron with the energy of the earth. Mm-hmm. Like the ruby, you get that root chakra in there, but you also get strength, more strength than you need. And you mentioned a rutilated quartz. Tourmalinated quartz. I like a rutilated smoky quartz.
Oh, okay.
Because, again, it's the dark and the light. You have the rutile in here it's... The contrast between that and the smoky.
If just because finding a rutilated smoky quartz may be a challenge, there's not like...
Okay, sorry.
a rutilated quartz with a smoky quartz, you can always combine.
Yes.
Like, here's a smoky quartz and a rutilated quartz. Remember, even if something's all combined, you can have, like, a couple of tumbled crystals and have a rutilated quartz and a smoky quartz, and you're going to get a similar effect.
You will. Just like if you used ruby and zoisite. I mean, there's ruby and zoisite, but you can get those and put them together.
Absolutely.
But they feel to me like I have a stronger and more vital connection to the earth during this time, because eclipses are, they're harsh.
It's important when you've got a lot of energy going on in the sky that you're rooting yourself to the earth, that you're feeling the earth, the other energies, the earth energy, the water energy, and not just all of that air energy flowing around. Okay. And then also, so a lunar eclipse is, that gives you the opportunity, the solar eclipse kind of lights up what needs to change. Mm-hmm. The lunar eclipse helps give you the ideas on how to change it. And so for a lunar eclipse, I like hematite. Hematite to me is, again, it's a mix of the dark and the light, because it's a dark stone, it's a grounding stone, but it also has like a very light quality to it, and I think it brings a lot of light into your life. And I think when you're feeling a little sad, a little moody, when you have to let go of something, because it really is for the best, hematite will help you get through that. The other crystal I like is a carnelian. Carnelian, again, it's a very earthy crystal, but it brings a lot of light into situations, and it's very good at helping you with change. And that's what an eclipse is all about, is it's showing you what has to change, and then it's trying to give you the energy to help you change it. And it's up to you to find out how to incorporate that in your life, and carnelian can really help you with that.
See, and I go the opposite. I try to make use of the energy as opposed to grounding, at least for my meditations and for my dream work. Mm-hmm. So I will emphasize it even more with the moonstone.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Because I really want to get as much clarity as possible. Mm-hmm. So when I'm dreaming or I'm meditating, I'm doing Reiki, moonstone is the one for me. It really seems to shed that light on any topic.
When you've got a lunar eclipse, that's an excellent time to be meditating or to, for dream work, that kind of thing. That's, and definitely crystals for that are wonderful.
Okay. For healingcrystals.com, I'm Lourdes.
I'm Tara. Crystal blessings.
Bye-bye.